Good morning and welcome again. During the last two classes, we considered different modes of discretization for solving problems on fluid flow. And in the last class, we considered a relaxation technique. So this time we will consider a similar technique called your successive relaxation technique, so also known as the SOR. So in comparison to the relaxation technique we considered in the last class, this method will converge the solution very quickly compared to the last method that we adopted in the class. So here you consider that you have the values of these flow variables at different grid points at the time interval t, and our objective will be to find out the flow variable at a point, let's say I comma j, at the time instant t plus delta t, that is at the next time instant. So from this flow variable informations, we are moving to the next time step to calculate the flow variable at the location I comma j. So this problem we consider during last two classes, and we adopted three modes of discretization and we try to solve this one. And here we will adopt this successive over relaxation, which is nothing but extrapolation procedure based on this idea as explained here. So you can consider this mathematical form that we considered in the last class itself. That means the value of psi at the location I comma j at the time instant, let's say n plus 1, or nothing but t plus delta t, when you consider the time instant n. So time instant t plus delta t will become n plus 1 here. So that is equals to delta x square into delta y square divided by 2 into inside bracket delta x square plus delta y square whole into inside bracket you have these two terms here. The delta x and delta y are the grid spacing along the x and the y direction respectively. So here inside bracket you have psi at I minus 1 comma j at the time instant n plus 1, that is it is from the present time step, that at the time step at which you are calculating, that is at t plus delta t. Then you are having psi I plus 1 comma j from the previous time step, because we are considering the latest value here as per the method we adopted in the last class, divided by delta x square, plus psi at I comma j minus 1 at the present time step n plus 1, plus psi at I comma j plus 1 from the previous time step n value. So that means wherever required we adopted the latest value possible. That means normally from the same time step we consider the latest values at the points where we have already covered. So normally the points will come on the left hand side or below the point presently under consideration. So here what we will do is that in this above equation we will interpret an intermediate value for psi I comma j, and that intermediate value we will represent as psi I comma j n plus 1 bar. So this is intermediate value, means it is a value in between the time step n and the time step n plus 1, or the time step t and time step t plus delta t here. So using this intermediate value, which we denoted as psi at I comma j at n plus 1 bar, so that you can represent like this here again. So it will be delta x square into delta y square divided by 2 into delta x square plus delta y square into psi at I minus 1 comma j at n plus 1 plus psi I plus 1 comma j at n divided by delta x square plus psi at I comma j minus 1 at n plus 1 plus psi I comma j plus 1 at n divided by delta y square. So here in this case we link between this psi at the location I comma j at the time instant n and time instant n plus 1 by a factor omega. So this omega we call as the relaxation factor, such that here you will write down psi at I comma j at n plus 1 will be equals to psi at I comma j at n plus omega into difference in the value of psi at the location I comma j at the time instant n and the intermediate position. So here you consider this intermediate one as the n plus 1 bar here. So that means psi into inside the bracket you left psi at I comma j at n plus 1 bar minus psi at I comma j at n here. And this value of this relaxation factor omega that we are using here, this can be found by a trial and error, such that this increases the rate of convergence for obtaining the solution of the problem. So, here the value of this relaxation factor omega can have any value which can be greater than 1 or also it can be less than 1. When this value of this relaxation factor omega is less than 1, then we say this to be the under relaxation, and when this value of this relaxation factor omega is greater than 1, then in that case we say it to be successive over relaxation. And when it is greater than 1, the value of omega, it can be in the range of 1 to 2. That means it can be greater than 1, but it should be less than 2 value. And when this omega is less than 1, that we say is the under relaxation. In that case, we will use this one when the solution will be oscillating back and forth between a limiting values. And this use of relaxation factor helps to reduce the number of iteration required to obtain the converged solution, because of which we obtain the solution at a faster rate and we will be able to reduce the total computational time and save lot of computational time, sometimes by a factor of 30. That means you will be able to solve it 30 times faster than a actual problem when we are trying to solving using a conventional technique that we adopted in the last class. So, this is the advantage of the successive over relaxation technique here. So, then we will see something called your numerical dissipation and numerical dispersion along with artificial viscosity. So, in fluid flow equations, we have a term called your viscous term, where this viscous term you will have something called your mu, that is your viscosity multiplied by some derivative terms. So, here you will see we will obtain something similar to this actual fluid flow equation, where we have a physical viscosity term contained in the mathematical form of the governing differential equation. So, when you consider the numerical solution of any partial differential equation, always it contains some amount of error. Already we know this one, because here we are using a truncation error with some of the terms only we consider, we eliminate the remaining terms here. And because of this one only, we obtain some amount of error in the numerical solution if you compare to that of a analytical solution. So, here to demonstrate this numerical dissipation, numerical dispersion and this artificial viscosity, we will consider a very simple flow equation that is called a one dimensional wave equation. This one dimensional wave equation you can write down mathematically, dou u by dou t plus a into dou u by dou x equals to 0. Already we have considered this equation earlier. So, we are very much familiar as on today with this equation. Here the value of a is a constant and greater than 0. And here our objective will be to solve this partial differential equation, that is this one dimensional wave equation, numerically, and we will see how we obtain a numerical effect which is exactly similar to a physical viscosity that we get in a actual fluid flow equations. So, here what we will do is, for the purpose of solving this equation numerically, we will discretize by using first order forward difference for the time derivative term. That means, while we go for discretizing dou u by dou t, we will use a forward difference, and while we go for discretizing dou u by dou x, we will use a backward difference scheme, that is first order backward difference for the space derivative term of this one dimensional wave equation. So, you can write down dou u by dou t using forward difference in time, that can be written as u at I at time instant t plus delta t minus u at I at time instant t divided by delta t. So, plus a into dou u by dou x using a backward difference scheme. So, that you can write down u at I at time t minus u at I minus 1 at time t divided by delta x. So, this is a forward difference, that is why I remains constant, t varies, it increases, and this is a backward difference scheme, that is why t remains constant and I varies, that is I decreases here, because it is a backward, we are going backward. So, now here that will be equal to right hand side 0 here. So, next what we will do is that we will try to rewrite these two terms, the first and the second term, by using the Taylor series expansion, and from that Taylor series expansion we will try to find out an expression for the first term and the expression for the second term in the discretized form of this one dimensional wave equation we have considered here. So first we consider, let's say, u at I at t plus delta t, and we will try to write down this value in the using your Taylor series expansion. So this idea we got from the first term here. Here we are having u at I at t plus delta t. So here you will obtain the expression for u at I at time t plus delta t using the Taylor series expansion. I have written here this first 3-4 terms here, you can see that is equals to u at I at time instant t plus dou u by dou t at location I at the time instant t multiplied by delta t plus double derivative of u with respect to time t, that is dou square u by dou t square at location I at time instant t multiplied by delta t square by 2 plus triple derivative of u with respect to time t at the location I at the time instant t into delta t cube by 3 factorial. So that becomes 6 here plus dot dot dot, like this it will continue. So here you can observe all the terms on the right hand side are calculated at the time instant t, and here delta t is the time step. So now here from this expression we will try to derive an expression for the first term here. So how you can do is that you can take this u at I at time instant t to the left hand side. So you will have a negative sign. So you will obtain ui at time instant t plus delta t minus ui at t. Then you require to divide by delta x. So both side you divide by, sorry, delta t. So that when you take this one to the left hand side and you divide both left and right side by delta t, whatever remain on the right hand side will be the expression for the first term here in the discretized equation. So what you will have here is right hand side you will have dou u by dou t at I at time instant t, you are dividing by delta t, so that is why this term will cancel here, delta t. Then the second term it will be same, from delta t square 1 delta t will cancel, so you will have delta t by 2 here. Then the third term you will have delta t square by 6 here, because 1 delta t cancel, like this it will have here. So you can write down them here. The expression for the first term here you will obtain dou u by dou t at I and t multiplied by 1 you will have, because delta t cancelled, plus dou square u by dou t square into delta t by 2 you will have, plus dou q u by dou t q into delta t square by 6. So this will be the 3 terms here, like this the remaining terms also you can calculate here. Then we will go for calculating an expression for the second term on this discretized form. So for this we will consider an expression for u at I minus 1 at time instant t here, not at u at I at t. So here you can calculate this one again using the Taylor series. Since you are having this one here on the left hand side at I minus 1 you are calculating, that is why in this equation on the right hand side you will have alternately plus and minus terms here. So first one will be plus, second one is minus, third one plus, fourth one minus, like this it will continue. Similar to the first case, here also we will derive an expression for this one. So here you see u at I at t is on the right hand side and u at I minus 1 at t on the left hand side. So what you have to do is you keep this term on the right hand side, you bring this term to the right hand side. So you will have negative sign here. Then the remaining terms on the right hand side you take to the left hand side, then you divide by delta x, so that you will obtain an expression for u at I at t minus u at I minus 1 at t. So you can obtain the expression for this one. So that you will get as, so this term goes to the this side will become positive, again you are dividing by delta x, so you will have here dou u by dou x at I at t into 1. This is a plus term, when goes to the other side become negative, so you will get minus into dou square u by dou x square. Again you are dividing by delta x here, so you will have here delta x by 2. Then this is a negative term, when go to the other side this will become positive, so this should be plus here, not minus. So 1 delta x will cancel, so you will have a delta x square by 6 here, like this you can calculate the remaining terms here. So now what you will do is you will use these two expressions and you will put here in this discretized form of the one dimensional wave equation. So you can put them here. So this term I have written here plus A into this term here. That is equals to, on the right hand side you will get 0 here. So now what you can do is, you can further rewrite this equation by writing the terms here. For example, dou u by dou t at I t plus A into dou u by dou x at I comma t, okay, plus terms multiplied with delta t you can write together, again terms multiplied by delta t square you write together, like this you can write down again. So you rewrite this equation. So once you rewrite, you will see I have combined this one and I have written it here again. So first term you have dou u by dou t plus A into dou u by dou x, so both the terms are at the time instant t at the location I, and here in this equation that is equals to 0, so whatever the remaining terms are there, that you will take to the right hand side. So on the, when it goes to the other side, they will change the sign. Here these are the plus term, all will have a negative sign. Here alternately we are having a minus and plus sign, so they will change their sign to plus and minus respectively. So right hand side you will have these terms here. So here you have two terms, again two terms, so four terms are there in the series, so you can write down the first four terms here in the series. So you will have on the right hand side, you are having minus of dou square u by dou t square at I t delta t by 2 minus dou q u by dou t q at I t delta t square by 6 plus dou square u by dou x square at I t at into A delta x by 2 minus dou q u by dou x q at I t into A into delta x square by 2, sorry, delta x square by 3 factorial, that is 6. So these are the four terms of the series. So these two terms you got from the first equation, these two terms you got from the second equation, like this. So now here you see, both on the left hand side everywhere, all the terms have been calculated at the location I at the time instant t. So since it is common to every term, we will for the timing drop this notation I and t, because we know that key all the terms are at the location I at the time instant t here. So I rewrite in a simple manner, dou u by dou t plus A into dou square u by dou x. But you see, this is the original equation from where we started. This is the one dimensional wave equation which says that right hand side it should be a 0. But you see here, if you rewrite this one by omitting this I and t subscript and the superscript, left hand side you have dou u by dou t plus A into dou u by dou x is not equals to 0 on the right hand side, rather than you have some value. So it may be a positive value or negative value at the end depending on their magnitudes, but you will get some value which is not equals to 0. But actually you started from it is equal to 0 on the right hand side, that means they are not same here. So this indicates that there are some error in the numerical solution we obtained, and this is because the truncation we carried out to the Taylor series we considered for discretizing the governing differential equation. So this truncation error with this difference equation, that here we have written the first four terms here, and that arises from the discretization of the governing differential equation in this fashion. Here you will see this truncation error will be of the order of delta t and delta x, because you see first term you are having delta t and here also first term you are having the delta x. So which will have the highest order magnitude for this delta t and the delta x? That means this term is the highest in magnitude and this term is the highest in magnitude for delta t and delta x respectively. So now I have rewritten this one by omitting the subscript I and the superscript t to denote the position I and the look time instant t here. I have rewritten it. Now what you have to do is, we will consider the terms on the right hand side and we will replace all the time derivatives on the right hand side by the space derivative. That means try to replace this dou square u by dou t square by dou square u by dou x square. So we need to convert this time derivatives into space derivatives. So one by one, step wise. So first you consider the first term here. You are having dou square u by dou t square, which is a time derivative. Then second term you are having dou q by dou t q. So these are the purely time derivative term. Then third you are having a dou square u by dou x square. So no need to do this one anything, because we are shifting from time derivative to space derivative. So this will remain as it is. Then fourth term, this is also a dou q u by dou x q. It is again a space derivative, so no need to do for this term also. That means we need to find out an expression for dou square u by dou t square and an expression for dou q u by dou t q as a function of space derivative of u. So let you number this equation to be equation number A. So to obtain dou square u by dou t square, first you take derivative of this equation A with respect to time t. Why? Because here you are having a dou u by dou t. So if you take derivative of this equation A with respect to time t, then the first term will become dou by dou t of dou u by dou t, which will eventually become dou square u by dou t square. And whatever the remaining terms you will obtain, that you can take to the right hand side, so that from equation A, by taking derivative with respect to t, we will obtain an expression for dou square u by dou t square. So first term you will get after taking derivative with respect to t, this become dou square u by dou t square plus A into dou by dou t of dou u by dou x. So this will become dou square u by dou x dou t. So this will become partial derivative with respect to t and partial derivative with respect to time t and x. So that is equal to, you take derivative of these four terms with respect to time t. So this will become the first term. So minus of dou t by delta t by 2 into derivative of this term with respect to time t. So this become your dou q u by dou t q you obtained here, minus second term, again you go for derivative with respect to t. So you are having a constant delta t square by 6 here, then derivative with respect to 2, so it is a third order derivative. Now this will become a fourth order derivative with respect to time t. So you get dou 4 u by dou t 4. Then you will have the third term here, it is derivative of this term with respect to time t. So you are having a constant a delta x by 2, then this is a space derivative. Now we are going for a time derivative, so you will have a partial derivative. So it will be dou q u by dou x square into dou t. Then you will have the fourth term here, constant is a delta x square by 6 remains here. This is a derivative with respect to x. Now we are going for derivative with respect to t. So you will have again a partial derivative. So you have minus of dou 4 u by dou x q into dou t. So these are the first four terms here. So remaining terms we are not considering here in the analysis. Then you see, this is the expression for dou square u by dou t square you obtained, but you see here you are having the term here. If you take this to the other side, so you will have dou square u by dou x dou t. So now we need to find out an expression for this one. That's why what we will do is, we consider equation A, again you take with derivative with respect to x here, so that when you take derivative of dou u by dou t with respect to x, this will become dou square u by dou x dou t. And here you are multiplied by A is there, that's why then you multiply this by A. So you take this term equation A, you take derivative with respect to x, then you multiply by A and you rewrite this one. So you will have here A into dou square u by dou x dou t plus A into a square into derivative with respect to x here. So again dou square u by dou x square. So that will be equals to, you have again these four terms are there, you take derivative of these four terms with respect to x, then you multiply by a. So first term you have a delta t by 2 is a constant multiplied by a, so you are having a delta t by 2, there is a minus sign here, then it is dou q u by dou t square into dou x. Then second term here, delta t square by 6 is there, multiply by a, so you have a delta t square by 6, minus sign is there, it is dou q u by dou t q is there, then you are taking derivative with respect to x, so you will get dou 4 u by dou t q into dou x. Then third term you will get here, a delta x by 2 is there, multiplied by a, so it will become a square delta x by 2, plus sign is there. Then it is a double derivative with respect to x. Now we are going for another derivative with respect to x. So it will become a triple derivative with respect to x. Then fourth term, minus sign into a into a square delta x square by 6. It is a third derivative, so now this becomes the fourth derivative. Okay. So let you write this to be equation B and you write this to be equation C. Now we need to use these two equations so that we can find out an expression for dou square u by dou t square. So what you can do is you can subtract equation C from the equation B so that we will be able to eliminate this term. Basically what you are doing is you are replacing this term by from this expression here. So when you subtract equation C from equation B, so this will cancel here and you will have a negative sign here. So you will obtain dou square u by dou t square minus a square into dou square u by dou x square equals to these terms minus these terms you will get here, and that you need to simplify and rewrite again. So I am to go, I have written it again here. So left hand side you have dou square u by dou t square minus a square into dou square u by dou x square, and right hand side you have these terms minus these four terms here. So you rewrite them here. So rewritten here. So then what we will do is that we will try to write in a compact form by writing only the first order terms. We will not write the higher order terms, because the more the higher order, the smaller will be in the magnitude. That's why we will be neglect them and their role will be minimal. So here on the left hand side you are having dou square u by dou t square, and second term is minus a square dou square u by dou x square. This one you take to the right hand side, so that the sign will become minus to plus. So right hand side your first term will becomes a square into dou square u by dou x square. Then you are having so many terms here, 4 and 4, 8 terms. We will only consider the first order terms, higher order terms we will not consider. So once you consider the first order terms only, so you will see first term you are having a dou q u by dou t square. So you write down here minus dou q u by dou t square multiplied by delta x by 2. So delta x by 2 here is common. Then next term here you are having a dou q u by dou t square dou x. So it is a delta t by 2. So delta t by 2 common here, that's why inside you will have a only, and other terms are we are neglecting. So write down of the order of delta t plus, then you will have the third term here dou q u by dou x square dou t, and here its product is a delta x by 2. So you are having taking delta x by 2 common. So inside bracket you will have a only. Then the fourth term you will have here will be dou q u by dou x square dou x q with a negative sign here. Then a square delta x by 2. So delta x by 2 taken common. So inside bracket you will have a square only with a negative sign. And higher terms we are neglecting, so we write down of the order of delta x. So let you name this to be equation number D here. So now see here you are having dou q u by dou t q, and we need to replace it by space derivative, because you see this we are trying to get dou square u by dou t square purely as a function of space derivative of u. So this is a space derivative of u, but here it is again a time derivative. That means we need to replace it by a space derivative. So you have to consider this one. Then again you are having another partially space derivative term and partially time derivative term. So you need to consider this two also a purely space derivative term. Here also you are having a partially space derivative and partial time derivative. This one also you need to convert purely into a space derivative, and this is already a space derivative. So this one and this one remain as it is. So we need to write down first, second and this third three terms, again you derive them. So first you consider dou q u by dou t q. So this is nothing but dou by dou t of dou square t by dou t square, and this is the expression for dou square t by dou t square. That means you consider this equation D, you take derivative of equation D with respect to time t here. So here you are having first term is a square, then dou square u by dou x square, you are taking derivative with respect to t. So you will have this one become dou q u by dou x square into dou t, and the remaining terms you will take derivative with respect to time t, and this will become higher order derivative. So we will write down as order of delta t and delta x. So, these terms after taking derivative with respect to delta t here. So, from here you will get, you can put this one here. So, you will get this one A into dou square u by, you see from here A into dou square u by dou t dou x plus A square into dou square u by dou x square equals to, you will get order of delta t, delta x you will obtain here. You can write, this is the equation C, I have taken from the previous slide, A, G, T, directly copied. And we will use this equation C and take derivative of equation C with respect to x, then multiply by A, because here you will see dou square u by dou t dou x is there, and here we are having dou q u by dou t square dou x. So that if you take derivative of equation C with respect to time t, this will become dou q u by dou t square dou x, and here you require dou q u by dou t square dou x, so that this we can replace it here. So you take derivative of equation C with respect to x, then you multiplied by C, so you will obtain A into A will be A square, dou q u by dou t dou t square into dou x will become plus A square into A becomes A q. It is a double derivative with respect to x. Now, after taking another derivative with respect to x, this becomes triple derivative with respect to x here. So, that is equal to order of delta t delta x. So, let you write this as equation E and let we write down this as equation number F here. Then you can use equation E and F here to find out an expression for dou q u by dou t q, because you see here you are having this term here, dou q u by dou x square into dou x square into dou t is here. So, you are having here a dou q u by dou x square dou t. So, this you can put it here. So, that you will obtain by taking this term to the right hand side. So, this will become a minus sign. So, minus a q into dou q u by dou x square, and then you are a plus order of delta t delta x here. So, that we have written here. So, it is minus, so you see it is a square into, for the whole term you are getting this one here. So, minus of this one. So, you get this term here. So, that is for this one here you obtained. Let you write down equation to be g here. Then we will consider, so that means here you obtained this expression for this one, that you can directly put it here. Then you will go for this term here, that is partial derivative with respect to time t and partial derivative with respect to space x. So, for this you consider equation D, that is this one, you take derivative with respect to x now here. So, you will obtain here dou q u by dou t square into dou x. So, here this is the equation we consider, we have taken derivative with respect to x. So, you will get this one here, it is double derivative with respect to t. Now, there will be another derivative with respect to x, that is equals to right hand side you are having a square into double derivative with respect to x, again we are going for another derivative. So, it will become a triple derivative plus other terms we are writing as order of delta t and delta x. Okay. Then you go for the next term here. For this, you are having a dou q u by dou x square dou t already there here, and this one you can for this you can, you have obtained written already got the equation here. From here you can write down, from equation E you will obtain dou q u by dou t square dou x square dou t will be minus 1 by a square, because you see this one goes to the other side, minus a q divided by a square. So, a square will cancel. So, you will have I think this, there will be A or something, you have to check it. So, you obtain this equation. So, you are getting here minus A into dou q by dou x q plus order of delta t into delta x square. So, you multiply here A q. So, A square will cancel. So, you are having minus A here. Let it be write down as equation H, and this you can write down as equation I, and these two equations will be used here. So, that means G is for this term, H is for this term, and I is for this term in the equation D. So, here you get this one, and for this you got here, and for this you got here. So, you can see in the equation D, which is nothing but an expression for double derivative of u with respect to time t. First term is a square into dou square u by dou x square. So, space derivative fine. Second term is here with derivative with respect to t, that we converted into derivative with respect to x. Then next term, it is a partial derivative, we now completely converted into derivative with respect to x only. Next term again it is a partial derivative, we again converted into derivative with respect to x only. Then last term again it is a purely derivative with respect to x only. That means everything on the right hand side on the equation D now derivative of u with respect to x only. So from here we started. So you get, on simplifying you will get dou square u by dou t square, you will get this equation here. So a square into dou square u by dou x square plus delta t by 2 into this term, a q into dou q u by dou x square, dou x q plus a q into dou q u by dou x q, like this you will obtain here. So let you write down this to be equation j here. Now we recall the equation j that is written in the previous slide. So here in this case you see, this is the expression for triple derivative of u with respect to time t here. And why we are writing this one is that here you have double derivative, here you have triple derivative, and this will be used in the equation A from where we started. So this was the equation A, please recall again. So here you have a double derivative term and also a triple derivative term. Otherwise on the right hand side the third and the fourth terms are purely space derivative. So if you consider equation J and G and that you use in equation A, we will be obtained all the terms on the right hand side on equation A will be derivative of x only. So using this equation J and G on the equation A, you can rewrite them, you will get everything on the right hand side as a function of x only. So it is seems to be slightly complicated, but it is not complicated, it is only lengthier only, it is not complicated. Now we will try to rewrite them in a slightly compact form by considering a delta t by delta x as, let us say, write as nu here. So that on the left hand side you are having dou u by dou t plus a dou u by dou x. So from this we started from the 1D wave equation. So original 1D wave equation says dou u by dou t plus a dou u by dou x equals to 0, but from equation A we got on the right hand side not equals to 0, and once you replace time derivative terms by space derivative, you obtain this one. And here we are using this notation, a delta t by delta x equals to nu, so that the right hand side of this equations can be written in a compact form as a into delta x by 2 into 1 minus nu into dou square u by dou x square, plus you will get a into delta x square by 6 into dou q u by dou x q into, you will get 3 nu minus 2 nu square minus 1, and the terms that we are neglecting will have order delta t q and delta t square delta x and delta t delta x square, also the term having order delta x q. That means having triple power all the terms we are neglecting here. So you see now we are able to write them in a compact form here. So this we obtained by combining three terms, and this we obtained by combining two terms here. That means 5 terms here combined and remaining terms we neglected here in this equation. So now here you will see this equation, which we started from the original equation of 1D wave equation. The original 1D wave equation having 0 on the right hand side, but here it is not 0 on the right hand side, and this equation is called modified equation of the 1D wave equation, where on the right hand side it is not equals to 0. So again I am rewriting the modified wave equation here, and you just recall the original equation dou u by dou t plus a into dou u by dou x equals to 0 here, and this is the discretization we considered. You will see we started from here, we tried to solve this one. So if you go for comparison of these two, you can observe that in reality this above difference equation is solving a different partial differential equation. We thought that we are solving this equation, but we are not actually solving this equation, we are actually solving another equation where on the right hand side it should be 0, but it is not equals to 0. actually you are solving the equation number 1, this one is 1 instead of equation 2 here. Now you recall the governing differential equation for a viscous flow, that is the Navier-Stokes equation, that is your momentum equation. You recall this momentum equation contains a term that is called your viscous term, which is nothing but mu into dou square u by dou x square plus mu into dou square u by dou y square, something like this. So if you consider the one dimensional form, so you will have one term that is mu into dou square u by dou x square in the Navier-Stokes equation or the x momentum equation. Here this mu is called your viscosity coefficient, and this term actually represent the actual effect of the viscosity of the fluid. And viscosity is nothing but the property of the fluid, and when viscosity increases, the Reynolds number will decrease and flow will become laminar, and viscosity decreases, Reynolds number will increase and flow will become turbulent. And we know the significance of laminar and turbulent flow, that means viscosity plays an important role in the fluid flow behavior. And here in this case, the modified form of this 1D wave equation, we obtain something similar to that of this viscosity term in the Navier-Stokes equation. You are having dou square u by dou x square multiplied by something, that is a delta x by 2 into 1 minus nu. So if you compare this equation, so we can tell that a delta x by 2 into 1 minus nu is similar to viscosity coefficient mu. So we can consider this coefficient to be equivalent to the coefficient mu here. So these terms represent nothing but this term here, which is equivalent to that viscosity coefficient mu, is represent the dissipative aspect of the physical viscosity on the flow, which happen in a real fluid flow. And here we obtain this coefficient, which is the coefficient of this term dou square by dou x square. Why you obtain here? Because of the numerical solution procedure, and this is much similar to the viscous term in the Navier-Stokes equation or the momentum equation. And here you will see the term in the modified equation is nothing but consequence of the numerical discretization that we considered here. This is the discretization form we considered here. Because of this, we resulted in this situation. Now if you consider this one, this is called your numerical dissipation, and this numerical dissipation is purely because of the numerical solution. It has no physical significance, because physically it does not exist here. For this reason, the appearance of this term within the framework of a numerical solution, this is called a numerical dissipation. And this coefficient of this term was a into delta x by 2 into 1 minus nu, and this acts like a physical viscosity, and this is called a artificial viscosity. That means just you consider it to be imaginary viscosity. And this artificial viscosity, or also we call as the numerical dissipation, it indicates the diffusive behavior of the numerical solution because of the numerical procedure we adopted. And this is the original equation here, and this equation describes the wave propagation through a fluid in one dimensional form. So if you consider a wave u having varying with space x, and let us say at a particular time instant, let us say when time t is equal to 0, its form was exactly discontinuous. That means you see here it was of this magnitude, and suddenly the magnitude have been varied from this domain to up to this is this value, and from here there is a sudden change in this value. It is at a particular time instant t equals to 0. Then you will see because of this viscosity effects, slowly as time progresses, the magnitude of u in this range from here to here, that means somewhere here to here, it transitions from this value to this value. So there is a smooth transition from one value of u to the another value of u over a limited domain length, starting from this value of x up to this value of x here. So this is because it is exactly similar to what happens in a actual viscosity of the fluid here. Then the reason for this one is that it is nothing to do with the actual viscosity, because here in this case actual viscosity does not exist because of the numerical procedure we adopted only. For this reason only you obtained this situation. Then there is something called your numerical dispersion, which is slightly different than the numerical dissipation. You consider again the same situation here. In numerical dissipation, what happens is that there will be continuous fluctuation of this value of u as u varies over this domain from this position to this position, and it makes a situation such that it transitions from this value of u to this value of u. And here you can see, here there is a fluctuation and here also there is a fluctuation having a different phases of the wave here in this case you obtained. This is called your numerical dispersion. So now question arises, why you have two effects, one is numerical dissipation and one is numerical dispersion, and how it originated from the numerical procedure you adopted. If you closely observe the modified equation, on the right hand side you have space derivative terms. Here you see you have double derivative, you have a triple derivative term. We have not considered the higher order derivative terms because of simplifying the mathematics here on this slide. You can consider the higher order derivative terms only. That means you will have something into fourth derivative plus something into fifth derivative plus something into sixth derivative, like this it will continue. So all the coefficients of this higher order derivative terms will contain some form of this term nu, which we defined earlier. So here you will see this numerical dissipation that we observed, this results because of the coefficients of the derivative terms having even numbers. That means here you have an even number derivative, that is double derivative. Then if you consider higher order, you will have a fourth derivative term, sixth derivative term, like this. So the coefficients of this even derivative terms results in the numerical dissipation. That means here this magnet term contributes for the numerical dissipation. Similarly, coefficients of the fourth order derivative terms also contributes for the numerical dissipation term. Similarly, numerical dispersion is nothing but as a result of the coefficient of the even order derivative on the right hand side. That means this term contributes to the numerical dissipation. This is the third order derivative, this is the coefficient of the third order derivative. Similarly, coefficient of the fifth order derivative terms will also contribute to the numerical dissipation that we observed in the last two slides. Clear? Okay, so we will stop it here today. Thank you.